In this session, I am going to show you how to create or add LDAP users and groups using LDF file directly, which is LDAP data interchange format. So we don't need to create a local users and migrate it to LDAP databases. So this is quite easiest way rather than creating a local user and groups. So I won't show you the entire procedure to setting up OpenLDAP servers. Topic of this video is to create a users and groups on your existing OpenLDAP servers directly using your LDAF file. Related links and document of this video are mentioned in the description below. Refer those links, that would be easier for you to understand this session much better from basics. Just to give you a note, if you need centralized home directory along with LDAP authentications, then you have to create a local user in the OpenLDAP server. Then later on, you migrate it to LDAP database and export the home directory using AutoFS or NFS to the clients, and which was shown already in the previous videos, links mentioned below, refer that. So users home directory also available from LDAP server to the clients. So there won't be any local user or no local home directory present at the client end. Authentication and mapping home directory will be happening through your OpenLDAP servers. But if you use a LDF file, which I'm going to show you now, is authentication will happen from LDAP server and home directory of the users will be created under each server. So the home directory of each user will not be available from your LDAP server. This home directory of the users will be created under each server, so data will be stored on individual client servers. It's all up to the requirement you have. So when the user is logging in, the authentication will happen only from the LDAP server, but the home directory will not be accessible to the client. Keep watching the video till the end. Didn't subscribe to LAN Etiquette tutorials? Do subscribe now and click nearby bell icon to get the videos immediately. For this demo, I have a running OpenLDAP server and the hostname is server1, and we are going to create a user called new user1 with UID 1010 with GID 1010. Let me show you my etc password file. I don't have any user called new user. So my LDAP domain controller name is DC equal to LAN Etiquette and DC equal to net. So first of all, we need to use the LDAP search command to print the object class details of all users and then find it for some existing LDAP user. Then we will do some changes to add a new user. So this will give you the complete user details object classes of your LANetiquette.net domain. Let me put more. So it is giving all your object classes including your main domain name LANetiquette.net, domain controller is this one, and the administrator of LANetiquette.net is a manager, and you have people group. And the list of users are John, his account is people, and his UID John, and his complete details of that particular user. What is his login shell and UID and GID and home directory of John. And if you do more again, then again you have a LDAP user 1 with these details, with this ID. Again you have LDAP user 2, again you have these many details. Then we have a group details with ID GID 1000, and for this group 1001, and for LDAP user you have this group. So from here, what you have to do is you have to take some sample object classes of one user and one group. So let me take that. So create a file. From this output, you have to take one user object classes. And paste over here. Again, copy one group object classes. And paste over here. Now, let's do some changes. As I told you before, I am going to create a demo user, that is new user 1. So replace all these LDAP user 2 username to the new user 1. So it has been replaced. Let me confirm that. UID of the user is new user 1 and its account is people. UID new user 1 CN, SN and mail ID of that particular user, this one, and object classes are this and user password. Yes, here what you have to do is you have to remove this encrypted password and you have to Crypt X, which means we are going to set a password for this user later on. So you don't need to touch anything over here, and here just confirm if you are okay with that shell UID, and UID you have to change. UID and GID you have to define for a new user. For here I'm going to use 1010, and for group of this user is 1010, and home directory let it be. And group here, yeah, CN new user one and user password, is that fine? And GID obviously it should be 1010 for that particular user. So we have made some changes for this particular user, and if you want to add more user, you can just copy and paste again and do the changes. Just save and exit from here. Now let's add the user into LDAP database. So here is the difference we have than local user and LDAP file. So we have not yet created any local users. Hence, we will not have any entry would be present in etc password for this new user 1. But the user will be in the database because we create a user using LDAP file which we have created now. Let's add it. -f to specify the file you have created. Just hit enter. So this will prompt you to enter the LDAP administrator password what you have created during the Open LDAP server setup. Hit and enter. So it has added a new entry into the LDAP database of UID as well as for the group. Now let's set a password for this particular user, hence you will not be able to log in. Yes to specify the password. -x to specify for which user. That's it. Hit enter. Again, you have to enter the LDAP administrator password to make the changes in the LDAP database. So it has been set. So let's verify the user been added into LDAP database or not using the command LDAP search. Superb. This is the output I was expected. It has given the detail of the particular user, new user 1. From here it has started. New user 1 account is people, and this is the detail of that particular user what we have created using LDAP file. Let's go to our client and we'll see we are able to log in with the newly created user, new user 1. This is my client, and already I have connected this client to LDAP servers. So if you don't know how to configure your Linux clients to connect with LDAP server, then refer the link mentioned below. So we are going to do some changes to create a home directory for each user when they are logging into. So just update the LDAP configuration to create a home directory, else you would get an error as home directory not found when the user gets logged in. So this is a command to update the LDAP configuration to create a home directory. Let's verify from this client whether we are able to fetch newly created user details or not using the command get end password new user 1. Yes, we are able to get it. If you see my local etc password file, it will not be a local user. So it has come from the LDAP server. So let me log in to the LDAP user, that is new user 1. So creating directory, which means it is creating a directory on your client. So I was able to log in this client using LDAP authentication. Let me log out, and if you see under home directory, you will be having a directory for this particular user. It was created now. So that's all. We are able to log in with the newly created user using LDAP file. So repeat the same for more users and groups. Hope you have got an idea. So keep practicing and have fun. If you feel something I have missed or you wanted to know more about something else, please leave your comments in the comment section and subscribe our YouTube channel for more updates. Thanks for watching this video. How did you feel? Is it helpful? Appreciate our efforts in the comment section below. Hit like button, share with your friends about us, subscribe our channel to get further updates. Stay connected with us on social networking sites. For more free tutorials, visit our website www.lanityguide.net.